So let's talk about the cancellation method. Talk about a seesaw. Let's say I have a seesaw here, and on this side I have a boy sitting with a mobile, and on this side also we have a boy sitting with mobile. Both are same mobile, the both boys weigh same. So in that case the seesaw would be balanced. It would be balanced. Now let's say by mistake this boy drops the mobile down. The boy drops the mobile down. Now what will happen in this case? Will the seesaw remain balanced, or what will happen to seesaw? Because now the weight of this boy and mobile, this is more, the seesaw is going to tilt in this fashion. It's going to tilt in this fashion. So it is not equal to now. Now it is not equal to. Now to make it equal to make it equal, what we have to do is, we have to ensure that this boy also drops his mobile. Now once this boy also drops his mobile, again, only two boys equal weight, so we will have a balanced seesaw again. We have a balanced seesaw. So now we have only the boys here and we have the balanced seesaw. Now let's say one boy gets down. This boy gets down. Now what will happen to the seesaw? Now there is no weight here, there is lots of weight here. So seesaw is going to be weighed in this side. Will go down this side because it is not equal to. So if I have to keep the seesaw equal, what I need to do now is I have to ensure that this boy gets down. If this boy also gets down, again the seesaw will be equal. So what we are saying is to keep the seesaw equal, we have to subtract the same amount from both sides. If we subtract the same amount from both sides, the seesaw will be equal. Or let's assume I add something. I give this boy, he had one mobile, I give him let's say a selfie stick. I give a selfie stick to him. Then I also need to give a selfie stick to him so that they are balanced. So whatever I am doing on the right hand side, I need to do the same thing on the left hand side so that this seesaw stays balanced all the while. That's exactly what we use in our cancellation or elimination method. So let's take one equation. 3x plus 2 is 11. So now we have a seesaw, and on both sides of seesaw, so on this side it is 11 and on this side it is 3x plus 2. Now they are balanced. They are balanced by the seesaw. So now what we will be doing is we will be subtracting this 2. So what I'll do is 3x plus 2 is my equation, and from that side I'm going to subtract 2. So if I subtract 2 from this side, I need to subtract 2 from this side as well. So I need to do the same operation this side to keep the balance. So if I do 3x plus 2 minus 2, what will happen? Plus 2 minus 2 will get cancelled and I will get only 3x, and that will be equal to 11 minus 2 is 9. Okay, now I am looking for x, so I want to keep x intact, but I don't want anything else with x. Now there is, what is there? There is 3 here with x, so I will want to remove that 3. So what I am going to do is, I am going to do 3x divided by 3. That way the 3 will get cancelled. So but if I divide this side by 3, what I need to do is, I need to divide this side also by 3. सो 9 डिवाइडेड बाय 3, डू यू एग्री? ओके, सो नाउ 3x डिवाइडेड बाय 3, दिस 3 एंड दिस 3 विल गेट कैंसल्ड, सो व्हाट रिमेन्स इज एक्स, एंड हियर व्हाट विल हैव 9 डिवाइडेड बाय 3 मीन्स 3, सो वी गेट आवर आंसर दैट इज एक्स इज इक्वल टू 3. लेट्स पुट द आंसर बैक इन आवर इक्वेशन टू टैली. सो इफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू 3, आवर एल एच एस वुड बी इक्वल टू 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3 प्लस 2. 3 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 3 इज 9 प्लस 2 इज 11, एंड विच इज इक्वल टू आवर आर एच एस. 11 इज इक्वल टू आवर आर एच एस. सो वी गॉट द सोल्यूशन विदाउट एनी ट्रायल्स. लेट अस डू दिस वंस. Is equal to 11. 4y minus 5 is equal to 11. Now, as we know, we need to keep the y intact. We need to keep y intact. So first, we are going to cancel out the additions or subtractions or anything which is not directly bound to y. So 4y, in that 4 is bound to y. So we'll not cancel that out first. We'll cancel that last. Anything which is not bound to y directly by multiplication or division, we'll cancel them out. So we want to cancel minus 5 first. To cancel minus 5, I need to add minus 5. I need plus 5. Minus 5 plus 5 will get cancelled out. So I will have to again do plus 5 here also. So whatever I do here, I have to do here as well. So minus 5 plus 5 gets cancelled, remains 4y, and 11 plus 5 gets 16. Now we don't have anything else other than the 4 which is bound to y. So now we'll have to move that 4. So 4 multiplied by y. So if I want to cancel out 4, I have to divide by 4. Because 4 is multiplied by y, I have to divide by 4. So whatever I do here, I have to do that same thing to the other side also. So I have divided minus 4 here, so I have to divide minus 4 here also. So 4y divided by 4 gives me y, and 16 divided by 4 gives me 4. So my answer is y is equal to 4. Let's do one more. Three fourth of x plus 2 is equal to 8. So as we said, we will 3/4 is bound to x by multiplication, so we will first cancel out plus 2. To cancel out plus 2, we need a minus 2. So 3/4 of x plus 2 minus 2. If I do minus 2 here, I need to do minus 2 on the other side as well. So 8 minus 2. So I'm performing the same action on both sides, so my seesaw is balanced. So this remains 3/4 of x is equal to 8 minus 2 is 6. Now what should we do? We have to, this is 3/4 of x means it is multiplication, so we have to divide this. So 3/4 of x divided by 3/4 we have to do, so that we cancel. So if I am doing that, I will need to do here also divided by 3/4, because I have to do same action both side. So here 3/4 of x divided by 3/4 gives me x, because I am cancelling them out, remains x. So here it will be 6, which is also as 6 upon 1, divided by a fraction. Divided, we convert into multiply, and the divisor we get a reciprocal, 4 upon 3. And that gives us 6 into 4 upon 3, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So that gives me 8 upon 1, which is equal to 8. Therefore, x is equal to 8 is my answer. लेट्स सॉल्व दीज इक्वेशंस यूजिंग कैंसलेशन मेथड. 10p प्लस 10 इज इक्वल टू 100. नाउ कैंसलेशन प्लस 10 वी वांट टू कैंसल, सो 10p प्लस 10 बिकॉज वी वांट टू कैंसल इट विल बी माइनस 10 एंड माइनस 10 वी हैव टेकन दैट साइड लेफ्ट साइड सो वी हैव टू टेक माइनस 10 ऑन राइट साइड ऑल्सो. So that becomes equal to 10p is equal to 90. Now we have to cancel this 10 which is multiplying p. So we have to divide by 10. So 10p divided by 10 is equal to, here also we have to divide by 10. 90 divided by 10. So that gives us p is equal to 9. So we are using cancellation method here. 3s plus 12 is equal to 0. We want to cancel 12 first. So therefore 3s plus 12. Plus 12 cancel. To cancel plus 12 we have to have minus 12 is equal to 0 minus 12. Therefore 3s is equal to minus 12. Now we want to cancel 3. 3 is multiplied, so we have to divide by 3. So 3s divided by 3 is equal to minus 12 divided by 3. Therefore, here it remains s. In division of negative number, first divide the weight. So 12 divided by 3 is 4, and 1 minus 1 plus different signs means answer is negative. So s is equal to minus 4. One more. 3p upon 4 is equal to 6. So this is also written as 3/4 of p is equal to 6. Now 3/4 is multiplying the p, so we have to divide by 3/4. So 3/4 p divided by 3/4. If we divide by the same number, we get 1. So here 6 divided by 3/4. So 3/4 gone, so remains p. P is equal to 6. Now divide, we convert into multiply because it's a fraction, and then we take a reciprocal. So 3 by 4 becomes 4 by 3. And that is equal to p is equal to 6 into 4 upon 3. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Therefore, p is equal to 8.
Simple equations is an interesting topic, and I'm sure you would love our other videos on this topic as much as you have loved this one. Don't forget to watch those videos and also subscribe the channel and click on the ring icon. This will ensure that you get notifications when we upload new videos. Happy watching!